Parashat Bo. Ve'avarti be'eretz Mitzrayim b'layla hazeh ve'hiketi kol b'chor be'eretz Mitzrayim. And I shall pass throughout the land of Egypt on that night and smite all of the firstborn of the land of Egypt. Somehow the whole miracle of Passover is built around the destruction of the firstborn. And this is very strange. What is there about the destruction of the firstborn? Why is this up front in terms of the miracles that God is doing for the Jewish people and for their freedom from slavery? And I believe the notion of the firstborn and the privilege of the firstborn was built into Egyptian society and built into ancient society. And what it said was that birth determines position. If you were born to a certain nation, you were the rulers. If you were born to a different nation, you were the slaves. If you were the firstborn, you got very many special privileges. Otherwise, you lost out a great deal. And certainly you understand that the house of Pharaoh, the pharaohs themselves, the firstborn, were the next kings. Judaism was waging a war against birth determination rather than merit determination. Yes, Judaism has a place, Kadeshli Kol Bechor, sanctify unto me every firstborn. We will read it in chapter 13 of Parshat Bo, whereas the destruction of the firstborn is chapter 12. But that's sanctification, and sanctification doesn't mean extra privilege, it means extra responsibility. And the firstborn is indeed born into extra responsibility, because if the parent is no longer able or alive to provide for the family, the firstborn is going to have to do that. So there is special responsibility, but not special privilege. And special privilege can never be a matter of birth. It's fascinating if you look at our patriarchs, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The firstborn were not the leaders. It was only the ones born after the firstborn. Very different from every other society around the Hebrews at that time. And the most amazing principle, which is the greatest principle of democratization in Judaism, is that Mamzer Talmid Chacham Kodem LeKohen Gadol Am Haaretz. A mamzer, a person the result of an incestuous or adulterous relationship, such an individual who is in the bottom of the totem pole, from a moralistic point of view, nevertheless, if he's a learned individual, if he has merit, he is to be respected before a great high priest, who has the best yichus, the best birth pattern imaginable. The mamzer comes before the high priest. if the mamzer is the learned and pious one, and the high priest is the ignoramus and uncouth one. So the Jewish battle against firstborn was a battle against privilege by birth and not privilege by merit. And as I've always said, if you want to tell me about your ancestry, I am impressed not so much by whom your grandparents were, but by whom your grandchildren are. That true yichus comes only from merit, and merit is never a matter of birth alone. Shabbat Shalom.